Alright, today I'm going to talk again about Constantine. I actually read furtherly that there's other information on him, different. So it was a little confusing here because I was trying to be a little bit of a relayer of what I had read off of his information out there on the internet, and I gave it incorrect, possibly. It is saying that he is different from what I was saying in the previous video. It was saying that he lived much longer, and that in that lifetime, oh my goodness, he actually did do things such as give bread rations, he gave grain rations to all the persons, all the people. So by doing the grain rations to all the people, it's very indicative, isn't it, of the kingdom here that I've created, the whole kingdom. Of the 20,000 for everyone also. It's very, very curiously close. But yeah, that was one of his majors that he did. But yet, in the same time, in the interim, there were many wars going on. And during those wars, and during that time frame, he did not want the women out, away from their husbands. He did not want the women out finding other men. And he made the rules extremely strict. And in this rulage, he said that they would be burned at the stake. And they were burned at the stake. So he was not necessarily such a great, cool fellow that way regarding women's rights and freedom to go find their lover. Because off they went to find a lover, and they were then persecuted into a pyre. This is a source on the internet, though. This is a source on the internet, so I'm feeling a little... I don't know, I'm feeling a little afraid out by it, because there's one information that said that he died within 2 years' time frame, and another says that he was doing many other things. Became Constantinople as his favorite home. So much so he did not ever want to return to Rome. He preferred Constantinople. So there must have been something delicious there in the food. I'm thinking the food and the environment of the air, perhaps the air itself, just felt better there, the food and the air. Yeah, and so there he is, and he's having his momente out there with I don't know, I'll try to calm down, but yeah, he was not so great, but with that one thing, he had to keep the women in the houses because war is going on. He did not want women out there in the street causing pandemonium extra. He wanted the wars to be the thing solved, rather. He wanted those little battles solved. He did not want the women creating further. There is also a moment where his wife, they say his wife Fausta, was actually went to the younger son, who was a stepson. She went to the younger son to be his lover, specifically to get him out of power. Did not want him to become a powerful next ruler. So for some reason, the wife is in there, and so there is kind of an interesting story there with Fausta. Fausta was quite the trying to take away the thunder, perhaps, of her husband. So it's an interesting moment. Yeah, no, the Greeks have so many moments, especially for ballet. It's such a tremendous. But does the audience want to see ballet and the Greeks? I don't see why not. I think it's a wonderful medium. That was really all I wanted to say, was my apology that I perhaps got it wrong. About the Quintilis being his usurper. That it was for someone else. And so yeah, I have to take that into effect. I can't remember if it was Wikipedia where I got my first information, but generally I do trust the information's out here. And so when I get another source, say stay indifferent, I'm like, oh my gosh, no, I don't want to fall into that. I don't want to fall into that where I have to go double check everything, you know. So I'll stay out of history, and I'll try to not be too demandant on this is what happened. I do want to talk though about body language, about our bodies itself and our inheritance of the actual puppet maneuvers that we are into, our movements. Where are they coming from naturally? And when you're saying no, not of the mother, not of the father, not of the persons where you were with forever and ever. For 20 years staring at and learning those movements and those habits, you know, not those habits. I'm talking really your true habits away from them, away from those two. I'm going back to away from the grandparents also. I want to know what are your true habits, just in your stance and the way you walk, you know, and how you are walking around. If you are the thunderer that just walks around and stomps everywhere, and what does that say? Well, it does go back to stating that you are very much more likely a military self for quite a lot of history. That you were a military self, and possibly just there's nothing more I can say about it, but that you were in the military. And when there are others that walk the earth quite lightly, you know, very, very pensively. What does this mean also? You know, so of all these different movements, and you know, everything, our body movements. So I believe in our bloodlines we find these particular mannerisms come out. And so in a way, when you're looking at a person, not in this time frame only, but try to look at them past this time frame, and it maybe can give you a different insight into the human being, one that may help you if you're having problems with them. It may help you. So, yeah. That's all.